Council before the sunset, and they prayed. And they asked the Prophet about the situation, and Al-Rasul approved both opinions. Only to tell you that at the time of Rasulullah, the differences started, but in little. Why? Not wide, because no need. Al-Rasul is there. He is the source, who is the source of Tashri'ah. هو مصدر التشريع عليه الصلاة والسلام. But after الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away عليه الصلاة والسلام, and after الصحابة الكرام went to الأمصار to here and there, you know, many of them they went to الشام, some of them went to العراق, after that some of them went to Egypt, here and there, اليمن, all over. And at the time of التابعين, they need many things, many new issues happen to them. They need an answer for it. So what they have Al-Quran Kareem. What else? The Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And do you think Al-Sahaba, who went here and there, Egypt, Yemen, Al-Sham, Al-Iraq, all of them, they had the same knowledge of Hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? No, Al-Quran the same. Al-Quran is the same, because Al-Quran is limited ayat, limited suwar, chapters. Those who memorize the Quran is the same. But Hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not all the Sahaba, they used to memorize and they did not narrate the same amount of ahadith. For example, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was the most Sahabi narrating, right? Until al-ulama, they give him a nickname. What's the nickname of Abu Huraira? Rawiyatul Islam. Rawiyatul Islam. What Rawiyah? The narrator of al-Islam. The narrator of Hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he narrated a lot of ahadith, radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa arda. And some sahaba, they narrated ahadith that others they did not. And they went all over the Islamic world at that time. So we shouldn't expect that all of them, they have the same knowledge, same narration. Now, what is the reason of the differences? Listen to this. The Nusus al-Sharia, the text of al-Sharia, al-Quran and al-Sunnah, we need to know a reality, that is a fact that we need, has more than one meaning. So listen to this equation. Since we have ayat, a hadith, text, has different meaning, plus different opinions of imams and ulama and mujtahideen equals what? Different conclusions. Different conclusion. That's obvious. But if I have muhkam ayah or muhkam hadith plus one thought equal one opinion, but which is not the case. Which is not the case. That we should expect this because of these two reasons. If we want to know the reasons of differences, al-ulama, they mentioned four main reasons why we have different opinions with the fuqaha. Why we have four imams, or more than four imams, and we have many opinions. There are four reasons, or four main reasons, if you want to say. Reason number one, al-ikhtilaf fi thubut al-nas wa adami. Again, here, in this reason, I'm not talking about Al-Quran, because Al-Quran is known, inshallah, alhamdulillah, till the Day of Judgment. Protected by Allah till the Day of Judgment. But for hadith, what that means, thubut al-nas and not thubut. For example, this hadith reached Abu Hanifa, but did not reach Imam Malik, for example, or the opposite. And now this Imam is mujtahid. Do you know the level, the rutbah of ijtihad, al-mujtahid? Is it the highest level of knowledge in Islam, al-mujtahid? He has to give an answer. If he doesn't have an answer from Al-Quran, he has to go to a Sunnah. If he doesn't have hadith telling the answer, he has to do his ijtihad. His ijtihad. In this mas'ala, in this issue, he doesn't have hadith. In this case, he did his ijtihad, his opinion. Other imam, instead of doing ijtihad, he has hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In this case, it's not allowed for him, Islamically or Shari'an, to give his own opinion. All the imams, Shafi, Abu Hanifa, others, they said, إِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثِ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي إِنْ صَحَّ الْحَدِيثِ فَضْرِبُوا بِرَأْيِ عَرْضَ الْحَائِطِ If al-hadith, I'm doing ijtihad because I don't have a hadith. I don't have any hadith in this, I do my ijtihad. But after I pass, after I leave this world, if you find authentic hadith opposed my ijtihad, throw my ijtihad by the wall. Don't care about my ijtihad and follow al-hadith. All the imams, they said that. But until he reached a hadith sahih, he has to give an answer, he did his ijtihad. So he doesn't have hadith. Other imam has hadith. The imam who has hadith follow this opinion, not opinion, follow al-hadith, the other follow his opinion. So we have two different opinions, obvious. The second main reason, if both of them, they have al-hadith, but they have differences about the rules of judging of hadith. Al-hukmu ala al-hadith. Do you know, ulama al-hadith, long time ago, Al-Zuhri, Malik, Sufyan al-Thawri, Ibn Uyana, all this, they did not have the same ruling to judge the hadith and to say, this is the rule of hadith sahih, and this is not. They have some differences. They have some differences in this. Some of them are very strict, very strict. For example, everybody knows Al-Bukhari and Muslim, right? Al-Bukhari and Muslim, Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim. And if you want to put who is more authentic, Bukhari or Muslim, the answer is Al-Bukhari, for one reason. What's the reason? Al-ulama, they didn't say because Al-Bukhari is taller than Muslim. There is a reason for this. Because Muslim said, if Abdullah narrated hadith by the authority of Sa'dullah, and based on the ilm of Al-Jarh wa Ta'dil that Abdullah and Sa'dullah, they live at the same time, there is possibility to meet that they met each other, and both of them are thiqah, trustful, is enough to me. Both are, with the ulama, they said, both of them are trustful, and they live in a time that there is possibility to meet each other. And one of them, he said, I heard Sa'dullah. Abdullah said, I heard Sa'dullah saying so and so, is enough to me. Al-Bukhari said, no, it's not enough to me. I have to be sure that Abdullah said, I heard Sa'dullah saying so and so. Is not al-an'ana is not enough to say, by the authority, Abdullah said, by the authority of Sa'dullah, Sa'dullah, by the authority of Abdullah. No, no. I want to say, I heard. That's why Al-Bukhari is more authentic than Muslim, and both acceptable and approved by all the scholars that both of them are sahih. So only to tell you some differences between the scholars. This imam, they said, both hadiths, they reach, the hadith reach both imams, but this imam, they said, is authentic. The other said, based on my rules, no, it's not. In this case, we have two different opinions. And the third reason, al-ikhtilaf fi turuq al-jam'i wa al-tarjih. Now, both imam receive the same hadith and all the ahadith, two hadith. And the hadith, the first hadith, the matn opposed the other hadith. I have two hadith, Both of them are authentic. But what's the context of the first one contradict with the second one? What should I do? You have one of two ways. Either to use both and combine between both, or to say, no, no way. One of them is right, one of them is wrong. This is at-tarjih. You have to pick one of them. Some scholars said, no, there is, we can't find a way to use both. He said, no, no way. I have to pick one of them. So this is easy. Reason of differences between the scholars, al-fuqaha, الاختلاف في الأصول وبعض مصادر التشريع بعض مصادر الاستنباط. Do you know أصول الفقه? Who heard about this word, this terminology, أصول الفقه? الأصول مصادر التشريع divided into two types. One of them are agreed upon and others not agreed upon. What agreed upon is Al-Quran, As-Sunnah, and two more. Who can help me out? Number three. Huh? No, no, no. Huh? Al-Ijma', Jazakallahu khair. Al-Ijma' is Al-Ummah agreed upon something? Khalas. It is kind of Tashri'ah. And the last one, number four. Who's Al-Qiyas? Jazakallahu khairan. Al-Qiyas. Al-Qiyas. Do you know what Al-Qiyas means? Usually I told the brothers, usually in Charlotte, I put a jar of chocolate here. If anybody answer right, I'll give him one. So you deserve one chocolate, brother. Yeah, Al-Qiyas. Do you know what Al-Qiyas? Al-Qiyas, if and Al-Quran Kareem, Allah forbid upon Muslim, upon everybody, to drink alcohol, right? Al-Khamr is haram. For what reason? Because يخمر العقل, cover the عقل, right? Affect the عقل. But Allah in the Quran mentioned الخمر. If the drugs haram or halal, we do قياس. The drugs does the same, maybe worse than الخمر. That means الحكم of الخمر is the same حكم of the drugs. It is an only example to know what القياس is. That's agreed upon. But there are many other qawaid. The scholars, they don't agree about it. I'll give you some examples. Qawl al-Sahabi, it is hujjatun shar'iyyah or not. The opinion of al-Sahabi. If one of the Sahaba said any opinion in fiqh, can we consider it as proof or not? Can we take it as like hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or not? The scholars, they don't agree about that. Some of them, they said yes. Some of them, they said, no, as-sahaba are not ma'soom. We cannot. Another example, ijma'u ahl al-Madina. What the people of al-Madina at the time of al-Tabi'in and Tabi' al-Tabi'in, the time of Imam Malik, rahimahullah. Imam Malik said, and Imam Malik was Tabi' al-Tabi'in, and before him was al-Tabi'in, and what's before al-Tabi'in? As-sahaba. And he said, these, our teachers, were tabi'in. And at tabi'in of al-Madina, they were the children of Sahaba. So any things that the people of Medina are doing in deen, in sharia, they took it from al-Sahaba. And al-Sahaba, they took it from Rasulullah. So he concluded that what the people of Medina agreed upon is part of sharia. The other imams, Abu Hanifa, Shafi, they said no. No, they don't agree with them. Another example also, if one sahabi narrated hadith, al-bay'ani bil-khiyari ma lam yatafarraqa, it is any this example all the time, they mention it. But the sahabi who narrated a hukum, a hadith, one hadith, but he does different than what he narrated. Some of scholars, they said, since he did different, he did not follow al-hadith, that means he's following different hadith. But he did not say. So in this case, they said, what he narrated, we cannot accept it. We cannot take it as is. Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, al-bayani bil-khiyar ma lam yatafarraqa. Also, Imam Malik narrated this hadith in al-Muwatta, in his book. He narrated it in authentic chain, and he said, I don't use it. I'm not following it. So do you think he did not follow it because he doesn't like it? No, because another reason. So many examples that al-ulama and they did not agree about some masadir at-tashri'. I mention one more example. هل مقتضى النهي الفساد? What that means? مقتضى النهي الفساد. For example, if somebody put his hand on a land, أرض مغصوبة, by force, he's powerful, his minister, his king, his prince, whatever, he took a land. He took it from his owner by force. And he stole it. Maybe stole it and secretly. No, he took it publicly. And that happened a lot, right? Back home, especially back home, not here. And it is big land. He took it without haq. It's not his. He took it from somebody else. And because he's the prince or the son of the king or et cetera, et cetera, he couldn't take it back. Then this man who took the land by force, he built a beautiful masjid in it. Big, beautiful, huge masjid. Maybe bigger than your masjid. The question is, if someone is allowed to pray in it, if you pray in this masjid, not your masjid, in that land, is your prayer acceptable or not acceptable? Is it valid or not valid? It is, there are differences. Based on this rule, النَّهْيُ يَقْتَضِ الْفَسَادِ. That means what this man did is haram, to take the land from others. If somebody pray in it, is his prayer acceptable, valid or not valid? The scholars, imams, they have two different opinions. Some of them follow this rule. That means this is haram to have this land, to build the masjid on in the stolen land. That means that prayer is invalid. Others have said, no, it's two different issues. If you follow, if you have wudu, and you have the intention, and you face the qibla, and you follow the pillars of the salat, your salat is acceptable. But no, don't pray in it, but if you pray, you get sin, because you pray in this land, but your prayer is acceptable. So you get the reward of the prayer, but at the same time, you're getting sin if you know this land is stolen and you pray. So you get sin from here and your prayer is correct, approved, acceptable. So these are the main reasons why we have different opinion in fiqh. So the conclusion is, and I don't want to take long time, is the ikhtilaf of al-ulama, the differences of scholars, is mercy, rahmah or not? To answer this question, we need to define al-ikhtilaf. If this kind of ikhtilaf is as I explained right now, yes, it is a mercy. But don't go to a very weak opinion, oppose al-Quran ayat, and oppose what Rasulullah ﷺ in a clear and authentic hadith, and you tell me this is rahmah. No, it's not rahmah. Al-rahmah is when you follow the other imams in the right and authentic proofs. So that's why I believe I want to say this sentence. You can follow any opinion with two conditions. Look at two conditions. If the condition, one of the condition, if this opinion has a proof, has what? A proof from Quran or from Sunnah. The second opinion If the imam or the man or the person who mentioned it is known imam, is famous imam, like the four imams and others. But don't tell me that a person, a sheikh, nobody knows who is the sheikh, and he bring an opinion oppose all the four imams and others. Allahu Akbar, you came at the end of the world before the last hour, and you want to oppose all these imams, all these 1400 years. So these two conditions again. First, if this opinion has a proof, and the one who mentioned this opinion is known, and known that he's fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not biased to by money, or he's close to this ministry, or this president, or etc. That's what I want to end my I tried to summarize as much as I can, because Brother Jafar promised you to make it short, inshallah. There is one more issue I want to mention, then we'll give the floor for question and answer, inshallah. If we have two opinions, these two opinions are authentic, and you are following one of them, and other brother following the difference. Is it, if I believe the opinion that I'm following is the authentic? Actually, you have to believe so, otherwise you cannot do it. The second opinion, also there is a proof for it. Can I, if I'm following one of them, say, you're wrong. What you're doing is wrong, is not acceptable. You have to follow the opinion that I'm following. You cannot do so. Because al-ulama, they agreed upon annahu la yajuz al-inkaru fi al-masail al-khilafiyya. If you have differences in any opinion, you cannot use the rule al-amru bil-ma'ruf wa nahi al-munkar. You cannot use it. You cannot tell him what you are doing is wrong, is haram, or is not acceptable, or is bid'ah, or is dalal. You cannot. We have to be careful, because unfortunately, some people, their mind is very, is not, I don't want to say this, is not wide. I don't want to be offended to anybody. Is not wide, either my way or the highway. That is the first. No. Especially brothers and sisters, because there are sisters over there. We are living in a community. We are living actually in a country. I'm not living in Lebanon. I'm not living in Pakistan. I'm not living in Egypt, right? I'm living in a community. At least, there are four followers of the madhab, followers of the four madhab, at least. I guarantee you that this now, the brothers who are sitting with me right now, I can find followers of the four madhahib. So, especially if you are imam, listen to this. Especially if you are imam, you have, if your university from where you graduate did not teach you the four madhahib, you have to learn the four madhahib. Alhamdulillah, University of Medina, they teach not four, they teach the six madhahib. You ask me, what are the three, the two more, right? If you are interested, I tell you. If not, I'll come. I'll continue. So, are you interested? Okay. Do you know Ahlul Zahir, Madhab al-Zahiriyya? Dawood al-Zahiri? Do you hear about Ibn Hazm al-Andalusi? Ibn Hazm, he used to follow the Zahiri Madhab. But nowadays, very, very little people they follow, very little shuyukh they follow, very, very little. And the second, JazakAllah, questions?
Yes.
That means I have to stop right now. Too much. Okay. And the second is Al-Zaydiya, Al-Madhab Al-Zaydi. Do you hear about Al-Madhab Al-Zaydi? Very close to, it's in Yemen, very close to Shafi'i Madhab, by the way, close, but it's different. So the point is, we cannot say my opinion is right and yours is wrong. We cannot use this rule. Otherwise, we cannot live to each other. Especially the imam, he has to know the other madhahib. I'm not saying he has to be mujtahid in all madhahib, at least to know the other madhab. If I'm Hanafi, I have to know the others, what they say. If I'm Shafi, I know to know what the Hanafi said, at least, and Maliki, what they said in this. Plus, you shouldn't, especially Imam, to be racist to one of these madhahib, even if you raised up as Hanafi or Shafi or Maliki. Don't implement and enforce your opinion and your madhab upon all the community. You cannot do so at all. You cannot do so. You have to be very logic and objective and realistic. You cannot force. Let the Shafi pray the Shafi, let the Hanafi pray the Hanafi. But if you adopt one of this, that's fine. And they are behind you, jazakumullah khairan. But you cannot tell this is the madhab that you have to follow. ما أريكم إلا ما أرى وما أهديكم إلا سبيل الرشاد. Yeah, the differences or this classification is not related to the fiqh. It's related to part of the aqidah. It's different. For example, Al-Ash'ariyah, most of them are Shafi'iyah. Al-Maturidiyah, most of them from Hanafiyah, as you know. But the Ash'ariyah are Shafi'iyah and fiqh. Maturidiyah are Hanafi and fiqh. So the point is different. This is not fiqh. I'm talking about the fiqh perspective. Fiqh perspective.
Sheikh, we start with the questions?
Of course. Go ahead.
So the first one I have says, Assalamu alaikum. Please explain the below hadith. One hadith says, no salah after asr, except qada until sunset. Number two, hadith says, pray two rakah when you enter into masjid. Which hadith to act upon?
This is one of, jazallah khair, I don't know. I like to ask one-on-one, is better. This good hadith, good question. Actually, it is good example of what I'm talking about. An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned hadith sahih. He disliked the extra prayer and nawafil to be after asr. At the same time, it is authentic hadith. Do you remember? We have another authentic hadith. When we have two authentic hadith, what we should do? Tarjih or what else? It is a quiz. There is chocolate here. Tarjih or? Tarjih or combine, exactly. So this is perfect example of this rule. When we use this rule, when I have two authentic hadiths, one of them said this is allowed, one of them said is not allowed. So the first authentic hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, don't pray nawafil, extra prayer after asr. The other authentic hadith said, whenever you enter the masjid, pray two rak'ah before you sit down, which is tahiyyatul masjid. Both are authentic. So Imam Malik, Imam Abu Hanifa, they went to at-tarjih, not the combine in this. They used the other rule. What at-tarjih? To follow one of them. One of them is more preferred, exactly, than others. They said, al-'am wal-khas. Al-'am wal-khas, the general, and specific or particular. And al-am is wider. Al-am is no salah. So no salah. Except what al-farida, right? Al-farida have to pray. And Rasulullah said, whenever you remember a mandatory prayer, you have to pray it. After asr, before asr, when the sun set, it is mandatory, it's different. And they agreed upon this. So they said, al-am yumuqaddam ala al-khas. The general, nahi, nahi, yani it is like forbid, we use it. They said, no tahiyyat al-masjid, no any extra nawafil, no sunnah al-wudu, no nothing. Al-Shafi and Ahmad, they said, no, there's exception. What is the exception? قالوا, ذوات الأسباب. The sunnah ذات السبب. Is not a praying two rak'ah, four rak'ah. No, there is sabab, there is reason. Tahiyyat al-Masjid is reason. Sunnat al-Wudu is reason. So with reason, reasonable or reason, if there is a reason for the extra prayer for two rak'ah, is exception. What's the proof of this? They said hadith, al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-tawaf. Why they said al-tawaf? Because what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about al-tawaf? Who knows? Al-tawaf is a prayer. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-tawaf is a prayer, but it's allowed for us to talk in this kind of prayer. And what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't, O people of Mecca, don't stop anyone perform a prayer, the tawaf, from any sa'ah, any time, day or night, after asr, after isha, after fajr, any time. So this is prayer. It's allowed because there is sabab. What's the sabab of the tawaf? دخول المسجد الحرام. When you enter, what the تحية المسجد when you come to pray to ركع. What تحية المسجد الحرام? Not to ركع. Is what? الطواف. And the Prophet said, day or night, any time, any hours. So I believe myself, I believe in this. Don't quote me. Don't give me that I'm Shafi or Hanafi. In this مسألة, I believe a Shafi and Ahmad stronger opinion. والله أعلم.
In a diverse community coming from different region, different madhahib background, what is your advice for people to refrain from criticism?
Criticism is not related to fiqh at all. It's related to akhlaq, to your iman, to your adab, tarbiyah. Even non-Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he said in Quran Kareem, وَلَا تَسُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Even don't insult the people who are worshipping idols, because if you do so, they will insult Allah. You insult their God, they will insult your God without knowledge. So we shouldn't criticize, unless if he meant scientific criticize, علمي, يعني, following the dalil with good intention. As we mentioned right now, I mentioned the opinion of Abu Hanifa and Malik, and the opinion of Shafi'i and Ahmad. Then I believe that this opinion is more authentic than this or stronger. In this circumstances, it's okay. But to criticize Hanafi all the time is wrong. My Shafi is not acceptable. It's bad. It's no manners in this. And not all the time. It's not true. All the time a Shafi is right and Hanafi is wrong or the opposite. This is when somebody start talking this way. No. Myself, I don't continue with him. I stop.
Inshallah. The same person asked the second question. Can one follow more than one opinion?
Can
we follow more than one opinion?
Can we follow one opinion?
More than one opinion.
In different issues,
and
different
mas'ala. The person is saying maybe...
That means in this mas'ala, I want to follow Hanafi, this mas'ala Shafi, right?
That's what the writer meant.
If that's what you meant, with one, I say yes with one condition. When you follow al-Hanafi in this, follow with the proof. You believe this, the opinion of Abu Hanifa in this mas'ala is stronger than al-Shafi. When I follow al-Shafi in this mas'ala, I believe the opinion of al-Shafi in this mas'ala is stronger than, not because because some people and the scholars, they warn us about it. Don't follow the weak opinions of the, not the weak, the easiest opinion and the weakest opinion of the scholar only because it's easier. No, we cannot do so. It depends of my mood. No, if you follow this because of this proof and this is no problem. In other way, that means I have to be Shafi all the time? No, Shafi himself said no. How about us? I have to be Hanafi all the time? No. But if I decide to be Hanafi all the time, that's fine. That's fine. If you decide to be Shafi all the time, that's fine. But if you want to follow sometime this and that with the dalil, with the proof, nothing wrong with this. Allahu alam.
Next question is, it wrote, if you pray in masjid and the source of money has not been halal 100%.
The same masala, the prayer in the stolen land. But many scholars like al-Nawawi and others, they name it, they give it a title, al-mal al-mushtarak. Al-mal al-mushtarak, that means some halal and some haram are mixed. If somebody, you know for sure that his money, some of it is halal, some of it is haram, if he invited you, is it okay to accept his invitation or not? Imam Nawawi, he said, yes, it's okay, because not all his money is 100% is haram. But I don't know what he meant specifically, this brother, but I don't think myself, I don't think in any community that all the money of the masajid is 100% haram. I don't think so. Maybe some of the brothers, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us hidayah, working in something has some haram. I'm not saying 100% haram, has some haram. Maybe he donate. Since he has halal money, why you said, you know, no, it is from haram. You cannot decide on this. Yeah, still you can live unless you know that the money, 100% they built the masjid from haram money, 100% that donation in it is haram. In this case, it's different, which is very, very difficult, almost important to prove it. Allahu Akbar.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam
said, "Chocolate? Yeah, good.
There will be 73 sects, and only one will be on what he and his companion are."
My mind is with the chocolate. Can you repeat the question?
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "There will be 73 sects, and only one will be on what he and his companions are upon, which group is this?"
Today, mashallah. First of all, this is authentic hadith. And before I answer, I believe I owe some of you chocolate. Somebody else also maybe come and it's okay, bismillah. You two, one for you and one for you. And you, all the time I give that children who attended the class, may Allah reward them. See this? Come. All the children, please come. Please, all the children, come. Come, yes. Yalla, your chance, come. Only those who are in the dars. This hadith is authentic. Come, Ammu, come. This hadith is authentic hadith. Is authentic hadith. Come, take one. Come. Don't be shy. Who said Salaam alaikum? There is another. This is authentic hadith. Yes. One of these 73 sects called Al-Firqatul Najiyah, the saved one. And when Rasulullah was asked, describe it to us, he said, Ma ana alayhi al-yawm wa ashabi. Ma ana alayhi al-yawm wa ashabi. That this group who are following me and my Sahaba. If you ask me to say, what is this group today? I don't have an answer for this. Because nobody knows all the Muslims. Do you know how many Muslims? 1.5 billion. And you know from where to where? From Australia and قبل Israel, اسمها البعيدة هذه مل لا اسمها أبعد اسمها New Zealand, tell Hawaii. My best, do you know the Imam Ismail, Muhammad Ismail? Tell Hawaii. You know Hawaii? From here, maybe 10 hours by plane. All over the world, there are Muslims. How come you want to define this group or that group? And I advise this brother and you too, don't put a lot of effort to know which group is Jama'at Tabligh or Jama'at Ahli Hadith or Ahli Quran. Don't. Work for yourself. Follow Al Quran wa Sunnah for yourself. Save yourself. Think about yourself. Don't think about others. Think about yourself. Say, I want to be among this group, the saved group. I want to be, inshallah, in Jannah. I want to follow Al Quran wa Sunnah. Forget about others. Your children are here. Please bring them to chocolate to get some chocolate. Okay.
Assalamu alaikum. I have lots of questions. If we go through all this, we'll probably be here past midnight. So we'll do our best, maybe keep it a little bit short so we can get to as many as possible.
For me, no problem, inshallah. I'm with you as long as you are. Khalas, samat alayna.
So, but we'll try to get to all of them, and if we missed some, we apologize. The next question, why is it not allowed to follow one or perform different things with different ways? Example, Salah by Hanafi fiqh, Talaq by Shafi'i fiqh.
Why is not allowed, you said?
Why is it not allowed to follow different things with different madhahib? For example, why can't you follow Hanafi fiqh for Salah and follow Shafi'i fiqh for Talaq? The person is assuming that it's not allowed.
I didn't say it's not allowed. If you remember, I said, if you want to follow the madhab, Hanafi or Shafi, all the time, is okay. If you said, I want to follow this madhab in this mas'ala and the other madhab in different mas'ala, I said, is allowed with one reason. When you pick, don't pick with moody decision. If you believe that al-Hanafi in this mas'ala is stronger, you have to. Or let me rephrase it. It is very good to do so. And you follow al-Shafi in this mas'ala because his opinion, you believe, is stronger, is something very amazing to do. So I didn't say you cannot do this or that. But